Hi, hello, welcome to yet another video. The background music was way too loud in this video, so I ended up just doing a voiceover. But regardless, I put a lot of effort into this video. I made a script, I tried to give my best tips and my most insightful information, and I really, really hope you enjoy. So in this video, I will be discussing my 1 month progress. I did the draw every day for a month challenge, and I did it from January to February. I just finished the challenge today, actually, and I will take you guys through my process, my progress, my improvements, my insights, and I really hope you find it useful. If you have anything to feedback or anything to say, really, I would love to know in the comments below. Please let me know. And I hope you have a good time watching this because I did put a lot of effort in. So I started this challenge on January 14th of this year and I ended it on February 13th of this year. So the same day that I'm uploading this video, I learned a lot and I improved a lot in this time. In the beginning, my color pencil drawings showed the graining in the paper. For example, in this, so did my graphite drawings. They were both pretty lackluster. And you can see it in this portrait of this man right here, which I used a lot of tools for. I used a bunch of blending stumps and everything. And then here with the frog, you can see completely through the paper and all the little white specks in the graining of the paper. Not enough blending and layering of colors was used, and I was not using the pencil in a circular motion. I was making linear strokes. You can literally see the lines in this portrait right here. This was my first ever colored pencil portrait. I actually posted about this on Reddit saying this is my first one and if anyone has any tips, and their biggest tip was to use circular motions to get rid of the graining and not linear ones, as you'll see the lines at the finished painting if you use. Sorry, I refer to this as a painting, but that's a little bit of foreshadowing. You'll see why in a minute. So I used a lot of black and yellow as well originally, which I really shouldn't have done. I tried to fix it in this one by using the pink. And another cool thing I did in this one was a DIY texture hack. So I used the back of a pencil. I like to use the color pencil I intended to use there in the first place because in case some pigment rubs off. And so this is the first step for me into the underpainting. Starting here, I finally started to use, not here, the next page. Oh no, not this page either. The next page. This is just me inserting smooth Bristol paper because I told myself to. So in this one, I did an underpainting. I started to use the circular motions technique and you can see very little of the graining in the paper, making it appear as a more seamless drawing. I also did the undertones, the pinks, yellows, purples, and other subtle colors under her olive skin tone, as if I was doing an underpainting in a painting, then went over it with a reddish brown and a yellowish brown to give her that olive color. I learned to burnish for the neck. I don't mind a waxy final drawing, so I learned I like to burnish early with beige usually and then add final details. Another graphite portrait here, and I like to think about this when I'm shading. Shade like you're sculpting. So this was February 5th and this was January 15th. And you can see my improvement in graphite. I was much more successful in achieving realism in the other one compared to the January 15th one. And I only use this WHB pencil and no other tools. More proof that it's the artist that makes the art and not the tools. Here is just some practice loosening up the hand. And you don't have to make every piece a final piece, so just, you know, doodling and such, and an empty page. And here I loved drawing this. I took my sweet time and implemented all my tips from before. I was honestly very proud of this and thought I'd already improved so much significantly. I even made a part one to this video titled How I Improved as an Artist after I finished this. And I have that linked in the pinned comment below. Some fun sketching, just for fun. I love the red with the blue. And then here I decided to try a self-portrait. I used underpainting, early burnishing, shading like you're sculpting, adding texture with the pencil backing and such all together. I have a quick time lapse coming up later in this video that'll show all the aforementioned techniques I used to achieve these results. Like, come on, the pimple looks poppable. Just the difference from my first portrait to this one is just wow. So this was February 13th, and then if I take you back to January 23rd, look at the shading up close in this versus I almost went from good artist to human printer. In another month, I hope to go from printer to AI.